Good afternoon. So today I'm trying to explain something about a work we are doing during these recent months, something like 1 year and 1 year more or less. This work is the result of a collaboration between a bunch of researchers, these the three of us. We are researcher with a background in hard science, especially network science, and we are collaborating with the archaeologist. She's Francesca Fulminante. Unfortunately, she's not here today, and she's the expert on the case study. So I have to say I'm sorry because I am a physicist myself, and I'm not sure if what I'm going to explain here will be, I don't know, you can find it weird or. I'm going to miss something about the case study or saying incorrect things in the archaeological context. So just briefly the geographic context of this case study is the Tyrrhenian side of central Italy, especially the Latin and the Etruscan area in the south side and the northern side of the Tiber River. Well, the chronology of this work is mostly the early Iron Age, and we are focusing on a period that is just during the urban revolution, something that happened at the same time in both regions, in Latium Vetus and Southern Etruria. And I'm not going further into detail, but then if you want, we can discuss this later. And we also have data about the very initial stage of this urban revolution, but we are not using them in this work. Okay, so this is the main point here, that is that our approach is a little bit different from what we are seeing in the other work, because in this case we are assuming that we know the map of the routes. There is general agreement within the community of scholars studying these periods and this area that routes are almost known, or at least this is what they say. And even if it is not possible to know everything with a very high accuracy, and it's maybe very likely that there are mistakes and small errors into these maps, we are just assuming that the general path of this connection is known. And then Francesca built these networks, in the sense of network, in the sense of graphs, from the maps, and then she's also improving this map with her own knowledge about this case study. And so this is what she did. From the map, she considered each settlement as a node and put a link whenever it was possible to reach one place from another one without passing through a third one. Then we added something about the geography in a very, very basic, minimalistic way. It is just the geodesic distance between the settlements as a weight that we consider as an attribute of the links. It's just very network science, minimalistic approach. But for the scope of this work, it's something that it's useful. Then. Okay, it has been done for the two regions separately. We have different network for Latin and Etruscan area, and for five time shafts. There are the age we were seeing in the previous table. So this is the main goal here. Is a little different. Is we want to investigate the mechanism that shaped this past communication infrastructure. What kind of forces were shaping this pattern of connection? And in particular, we are interested in trying to understand if such mechanisms stay the same or change over time. So what we are doing here is try to identify some particular pattern feature of these networks, and then based on that, on these features, these particularities, we try to make hypotheses, and then to build models. The second step is try to build models that are simple models in order to determine which one of these models fit better, that is, which mechanism is the most important. So we focus first on the Southern Etruria, and we analyze that the network resulting from Francesca's work. And these are just some measures that we consider relevant. This is just the number of nodes that is increasing through time, and then the number of links of edge for each node, the total length of these links for each node on average, then the fraction of closed triangles we can find in the network, and then the length of the average shortest path between pair of nodes, and finally something that we consider is the most important part of this analysis. There are the local and global efficiency. We selected this feature as the most significant ones because of two reasons. The global efficiency that is somehow a measure of how short the shortest path are when compared with the direct connection, the geodesic connection, is very high. It was something that compared with similar network of other age or modern infrastructure is almost is interesting, is something that got our attention. And the local efficiency is also interesting because it's monotonically, it's increasing through time, and the difference between the initial and the final value is relevant. I mean, it's one and a half time higher. So let me just add some little disclaimer here that the model I'm going to present here are not trying to emulate the real process. This is not the our aim. But they are interesting because they are very simple, and so we can say we know everything, we can control everything about the model. Starting from this complete control we have, we are able to do something more. If comparing the output of the models with empirical networks, we are able to identify clear differences and similarities, maybe then we can learn something about the forces that shape it and govern the real process. Not just because the process was the same as what we see in the model, but because there is some kind of analogy. Of course, there is a huge, large, broad spectrum of possibility, and the real, the archaeological evidence, the real roots are the result of a combination of several different ingredients. But maybe we can identify the most relevant ones, or at least distinguish between basic fundamental options, like if there were some kind of mechanism, coordinated or non-coordinated decision making behind the building of a new route. So here we are proposing three simple models corresponding to three different hypotheses, and then we are comparing this model with the empirical network in order to understand if which of the three mechanisms, or maybe none of them, is more likely to explain something. So the first model is very, very simple. In many cases, it could be regarded as a null model because it's just the random connection with the nearest neighbors, the nearest settlement. In this case, we can say that each node tries to connect with as many neighbors as possible, and just competing with the other with no strategic thinking, and just blind competition over finite amount of resources. What we do practically is just we take from the data the position of the node, the coordinates, the geographic coordinates of each settlement, and then we measure the total length of the connection. And this is something that we put into the model. Then this is the kind of network we obtain. This One realization is we can realize this process many times, as many as we want. This is another one. Sometimes we obtain a result that is not connected. The network is fragmented, so it's not very good. In particular, comparing this artificial network with empirical ones, we find that is overestimating the number of connections and the number of triangles. There are many, many triangles here. And also the local efficiency, that is this kind of resilience of the system when one node is knocked out. And so this is too high in the system, while the global efficiency is too low. So there are many problems here, but just to make it clear, more clear, let's see. This is how the things work here. This is the empirical network corresponding to the early Iron Age one early, and this is what the model is doing. It's constructing here, adding links according to this algorithm. Okay, so this is the final result. All this zone here, this area where we have a long-range connection in the real system, they are completely missing in this model. So this model is not good enough. So we tried to improve it a little bit, and we introduced some local strategic thinking. In this case, each node, instead of trying to connect with the closest one, are trying to connect with other settlements that are not already easily connected. There is an already existing path that is short enough, they discard that settlement and go for another one that is hardly connected. So again, from the data, we take the position and the total length, and then we obtain something that do just the opposite than the previous model. We have too few triangles, too few connections, the local efficiency is not good enough, while the global one is very similar to the empirical network, but in the end, okay, you can see here, we have too many long-range connections in this case. And this is a direct comparison without any animation. So this doesn't really make sense. So we try something different. In this case, we have a model that's even simpler, because in this case, it is a deterministic model. Just one possible realization, because the criterion is the same as in model 2, but the ordering of the priority of the links is globally determined. So we have some kind of global strategic planning behind the construction of new connection. This is the same as always, and then this is what we have. This is one of the empirical network, and this is the corresponding artificial one. This is just one. We don't have many realizations here. And so we are doing something better in this case. These areas correspond to these areas, not exactly the same, but the general pattern is almost accurately reproduced. And also this area, the amount of triangles, in general, they are very, very similar to the empirical ones, and in particular, the two efficiencies we are considering are almost the same, both in the artificial and the empirical network. Okay, let's see how it works. The beginning is very slow because it starts building short links, because if it's possible, the priority is given to the shortest one. But then they get longer and longer. So and the system is able to cover all the area without wasting connection, repeating something that is not useful, because it's already possible to reach the place. Almost done. This is just skipping the last part. Okay, so the idea here is that we maybe are able to learn something about the real mechanism, because the similarity is very high. And just summarizing, and this is the measure we were focusing on. This is the number of connection and then fraction of triangles. This is the first model in yellow, the second one in green, and the third one in orange, red. And this is the empirical. So they are very, very similar. And in this case, as we say, model 2 is good as well, but model 3 is not any less. And this is the local efficiency. So we can try to extract some legitimate conclusion. We can say that model 3 is very good, but of course we cannot say it's the best possible model. But anyway, we can say that another model that is equally good and at the same time equally simple is very hard, very unlikely to exist. And so probably this idea of global strategic planning can be at least it can be regarded as the most simple explanation at hand. Of course, in this case, we are looking at the time shots separately, so we cannot take it like a literal reproduction, I don't know how to say, but it's not an emulation of the real process. So it's not like the Etruscan destroyed the rose 5 times and built them all over again through this kind of process. But in any case, the connections are as good as if they did it. And just as let me add something about Latium Vetus. In this case, things are quite much more complicated. And this is just the same plot I showed before. In this case, for this other reason, model 2 sometimes behaves better than model 3. Like in this case, model 3 is the best one, but in the other one, it is not. And with efficiency, we have very ambiguous behavior in the case of the global one, while in the local one, it looks like the model 2 again is the best one, but at visual inspection you will immediately notice that these networks are not that good it seems here. And about model 3, we can say that at first sight there is some differences that deserve some attention. For instance, this is a very silly question, but where is Rome in this network? In the empirical one, it is very clear that there is a node that is the most important one, and it is here. But here, this is not any special. So we thought that probably the heterogeneity is playing some important role here, and we decided to modify this model, adding a touch of preferential attachment. It is a little bit of a rich get richer. In this case, in this way, with this kind of a little adjustment of the modification of the model, then Rome naturally show up. We are not imposing anything, just position of the nodes and no information about importance, sites, or anything else. Just with this simple mechanism, it is Rome, the most important node that emerged naturally. So, the conclusion. We can say that the mechanism that generated the connectivity pattern in Southern Etruria and Latium Vetus are similar, because the results are not that different, but they are not identical. And in Southern Etruria, networks are easier to be reproduced artificially. Model 3 works just fine. But and we can get interesting insight from that. But in Latium Vetus, we are observing, we are in a situation of unbalanced power that led to the emergence of Rome, and this is this implies that this competition that we are observing in model 2, we are reproducing in model 2, is able to reproduce some feature of these networks. Well, model 3 need to be corrected in order to take these circumstances into account. Then this is good, this is something nice, because it implies that terrestrial routes are somehow affected by these unbalanced forces and can reflect something about the process that were going on in, at those time. And then we do, when we do that, with when we correct the model, we have that Rome show up naturally. While in Southern Etruria, we have just this kind of more equilibrated system, and the model that is just coordinating the resources at global level is the best one. And there is no change through time. That is, this model is equally good in all the ages considered. So we can say that about our initial question, if the mechanism stays the same or not, that yes, in the case of Southern Etruria, it stayed the same. And that's all. Thank you.